Yep. So our today's topic, that is atomic structure and isotopes. First of all, that atomic structure, that means as usual that you know that each and every element that is made up of million trillions of atoms. So fundamentally that what's our atom, as I explained in many of other class videos, that atoms are the simplest particle which are dependent in nature. Here just be careful, I am not saying independent, I am saying that atoms are simplest particle which are dependent in nature. Why I am saying that dependent in nature? Because they are made up of electron, proton and neutron and many other subatomic particles. Okay. Understand?
Yeah.
And also, so that means electron, proton means three fundamental or primary particles are electron, proton, neutron. Electron is invented by J.J. Thomson, proton by Goldstein, and neutron by James Chadwick. Okay. Electron was invented in 1872. Proton has been invented, proton had been invented in 1878 and electron had been invented in 1932. Okay. So also atomic structure, beta. In atomic structure, what the main things that you have to learn there, okay, before scrolling down, fundamentally that I have to explain that to you. There will be an atom. So if there will be atoms, so regarding to electron, proton and neutron, firstly we have to understand that what's the main thing which we have to understand over there. So first of all, just see on your screen, are you able to see clearly on your screen?
Yeah.
Suppose that this small yellow circle you are seeing over here, okay, it is your nucleus, okay?
Okay.
Around this one, there will be imaginary path, okay, which generally known as orbit, okay?
Orbit, yeah.
Yeah. And also, so the center one, that is known as your nucleus.
So is around that is around orbiting protons and neutrons, I mean protons and electrons.
Wait, hold on. Yeah, give me 1 second. Oh my god, what is happening? Give me 1 second, sorry. Actually, wait. So first orbit that will be here, second orbit that will be here, and then we can choose the white color. Yes, so here it is your nucleus. Okay, in a nucleus always remember that there will be proton and neutron. Okay.
Okay,
proton and neutron, they will be in nucleus. So here there will be proton plus neutron. Okay, proton always becomes positively charged. Okay, proton that is positively charged. Okay, positive. Electron that is your negative charge. Okay, and a neutron that is the neutral. Okay.
Okay.
Yeah, that means having charge, no charge or chargeless. Okay, basically proton and neutron that will be in the nucleus, and electron would like to revolve around the nucleus. Wait a second, I have to choose another color. Give me a second. I think yes. Yes, these are electrons. Okay, in a fixed imaginary path having constant energy level. Okay, and these paths are known as orbits. Okay.
Okay.
So basically that it is the basic thing which you have to learn. So these are also known as imaginary path, they are known as orbit, or also in the terms of atomic structure we can configure that as shells. Okay, so that means fundamentally what you have to learn, that means in atom, okay, protons and neutrons will be in nucleus. Okay, and electrons would like to revolve around the nucleus in an imaginary path known as orbit. Okay.
Yeah.
All these orbits are generally configured as shells. Okay.
Yeah.
And fundamentally, as I explained that to you, there are three subatomic particles which are known as proton, neutron and electrons. Proton and neutron combinedly are known as nucleons, okay?
Yeah.
Nucleons, okay? There are also other videos which you can see related to this one. Oh yes, that's the great thing. Here you can see that atomic structure. In this section that we would like to understand about the nuclear model of an atom. So here you can see that in nuclear model you are seeing that at the center there is nucleus, in which one there will be proton plus neutron, okay?
Yeah.
And whatever red one you are seeing around it, they are electrons, okay?
Yeah.
They are electrons. These are electrons. Electrons, okay? And then it is defined as the structure of atom, and whatever you are seeing that with respect to light means blue and a little bit shining color, that is known as orbits, okay?
Okay.
Yes, atom contains three subatomic particles, as I explained that to you, proton, neutron and electron. Proton and neutrons are found. Wait, let me refresh that, because I have to underline something which you have to be understand over there. Give me 1 second. Yes, yes, again came. So now I'll be able to. Yes, there are. Yeah, it is whatever that you are seeing picture, that is your structure of atom. Okay, there are atom contains three subatomic particle, proton, neutron and electrons. Okay. Yes. Always remember that protons, that is subatomic particles having positively charge, okay, having positive charge and relative mass, that is 1, okay. Neutron, that means neutral they becomes, okay, that means uncharged, with the mass of 1 relative to a proton. And electrons, they are subatomic particles having negative charge, okay, and relative mass, that is with respect to proton and neutron. Understand?
Yeah.
Clear?
Yeah.
And as I explained that to you just before, that proton and neutrons are found in the nucleus at the center of the atom. Yeah, you can see that here at the center. At the center. Okay.
Yeah.
Nucleus of an atom that is very small than the atom as a whole. Okay.
Yeah.
Electrons would like to distribute it in different energy levels surrounding the two nucleus, okay?
Yeah.
Understand? So here basically that what you have to see, yeah. So proton, that is positively charged, neutron, that is neutral, and electrons, that are negatively charged, okay?
So can you just scroll off for a minute? I just wanted to see the diagram.
Oh yes.
Oh, okay.
Yeah, yeah. Here at blue part there will be proton and neutron. Proton is positively charged and neutron, that is chargeless. And outside of that you can see that two shells, that it is drawn here, and in two shells you can see that number of electrons are there, okay? That's why that there is a common thinking that proton and neutrons, they are in the nucleus, that's why that they are also known as nucleons, and electron used to revolve around the nucleus, okay? Actually, when J.J. Thomson invented electron, okay?
Yeah.
So he explained that electrons are negatively charged particle, okay, which used to revolve around the nucleus, okay? Then as usual, you know that if any object that contains energy, okay, and if that is revolving around something, then 100% that with the time that energy would like to dissipate or not.
Yeah.
So if the energy would like to dissipate, then one time will come that the electron would like to opt a spiral path, and one time will come it would like to collide into nucleus.
Okay.
But it doesn't happen. Why? Then Thomson was not able to explain this one. Okay, means suppose that that suppose electron that is revolving around the nucleus, okay? So then it will start from here, because that with the time that its energy that would like to dissipate, okay? And then less energy, and the last it will collide into the nucleus. Okay? But it doesn't happen. Okay? And then the atom existence that will come to end. Okay? But it doesn't happen. Why? Actually, Thomson was not able to explain this one. Okay? Then in 1895 to 1905, okay, there was another scientist, well known scientist named Einstein. Okay, Einstein was a well known scientist who explained different theories with respect to energy. Okay, then Einstein explained that all these shells, all these orbits, they are of all orbits are of constant energy levels. What do you mean by constant energy? Constant energy, that means, it means that its energy will never increase or decrease. Okay. So that means what? If you are running on a path and that's energy is neither increasing nor decreasing, so that means constantly that you would like to move on that path or not.
Yeah.
Or suppose that if you are running in a car, okay, and that's energy or that's petrol will never end, okay? So in that condition, that in finite times that you would like to, okay, in finite times you would like to move, okay, from one place to another place, and your energy will not decrease. You can also understand in this way. Suppose that when a baby tend to born, okay, after birth, then the first day of the birth, then the energy of the body that would like to start to decrease, okay? Understand? And then time after time, energy would like to decrease, then a child would like to come into adolescence, and then it would, and then he would like to be adult, and then got married, and then produce some childs, and also at the end of getting old, and then one day will come that when he will die. So what is the main factor? What is happening there? From the starting of his birth, that means the first day of his birth, his energy, his body's energy that would like to decrease, okay? And when all the energy of the body that would like to end, then that will be the last time to end the life, okay? So it means that, suppose that, just imagine that if your body's energy will not decrease, then what will happen? That means, you will be immortal.
Yeah.
Yes, because means anyone, you, me, anyone. Suppose that if my body's energy will not decrease, so every time that I would like to be just like as a newly born baby.
Yeah.
My body would like to be enlarged. Okay. I would like to be means a little bit 100 years or 200 years or 500 years old. Okay. But then it will not affect my body, because the energy is not decreasing there. Okay, so that's why that I would like to be immortal.
Okay,
but it doesn't happen in our real world, beta. Each and everything which contains energy, each and every time that it would like to decrease. Okay, it would like to decrease its in amount, and one day will come that when due to deficiency of energy, that object existence that will be and. Okay.
Yeah.
Do you understand that?
Yes.
Always remember that, as I explained that to you before, that if an atom loses electron, then that will be electropositive. Okay.
Okay.
If an atom loses electron, atom or means suppose that element, you can also say suppose that well-known element sodium, when loses electron, Na minus E minus, that will give you Na plus. Okay. So it is your electropositive. Okay.
Okay.
Electropositive. Or also that we can see that they are known as cations, okay? Cations, understand? And on other hand, if other atom that would like to gain electron, like chlorine, when it will gain electron, then it will form chlorine ion Cl minus. It will be your electronegative, okay? Okay, and then it is known as an ion. Okay.
Okay.
Clear?
Yeah.
Great. So, do you understand it?
Yeah.
Very good. So your class is recording, beta. After your class, within 2 or 3 hours, I will upload this one on channel. Okay. Also, there are other students' classes regarding to atomic structure, isotopes and all that. So, you can also go to there and you can also get knowledge.
So, what are isotopes?
Yeah. Pardon?
What are isotopes?
Isotopes, that means having same atomic number but different atomic mass.
Oh. Isn't like the term isotope used in geography as well?
Pardon?
Isn't the term geography, the term isotope used in geography?
Isotopes? Oh, yes.
Yeah. Okay, because I got a bit confused. Like,
No. Actually, they suppose that there is any substance, okay? So isotopes, that means having same atomic number. You can take example. You can take example of carbon. Okay, we would like to reach over there, beta. But before that, whatever that remaining things that we have to understand over here. Okay, then I'll explain clearly. Atomic number. Fundamentally, you have to understand that atomic number is defined as atomic number. That means the number of electrons. Okay.
Yeah.
Electrons or number of protons. Okay. Protons. Okay, that means what you can write over there, what you can write or what you can understand. That means atomic number equals to number of protons equals to number of electrons. Okay, that's it.
Okay,
so that means how much will be the number of electrons, okay, in an atom, that is considered as atomic number. Okay. And next is, what is mass number? Okay, so mass number, that means the total number of proton and neutron inside the nucleus. Okay.
Okay.
Yeah, mass number, that means total, that is proton plus neutron, okay, in nucleus. Okay.
Yeah.
Okay, understand?
Yeah.
Great. Yes, but just to understand carefully, because that after these 3 pages there will be a test which will be conducted and you have to give answer of those questions. Report will be given to your father. Okay.
Okay.
Yes, so do you understand atomic number and mass number? Atomic number, that means the number of electrons present in an atom, that is known as atomic number. Okay.
Yeah,
means either you can say that the number of electrons, or also you can say that number of protons. Because in an atom, the number of electrons or number of protons, they are same. Okay.
Okay.
Okay. Next is full chemical symbol. In here. And also just you have to understand that the mass number of an atom is never smaller than its atomic number. Okay.
Okay.
Yeah. Either that will be equal or 100% that will be greater than atomic number. Okay. So that means mass number is always greater than atomic number. Okay.
Yeah.
Always. Means okay. Here that whatever periodic table that we know that approximately almost all the elements have their mass number approximately double of their atomic number, you know.
Oh, so like 17 is almost doubled as 35.
Yeah, suppose that chlorine, wait, I can explain that to you. It's a very easy to understand. Suppose that chlorine atomic number 17, okay. So yeah. Atomic mass that will be 35, okay. Chlorine has three atomic masses, okay? 34, 35, 36. Oh, no, sorry. I think that 35, 36, 37, okay?
So, okay. Yes.
So, in that condition, what you have to understand that approximately that will be double. Means suppose that other example you can take that like oxygen, okay? So, oxygen atomic number that is 8 and atomic mass that is 16.
Okay.
Just double, okay? Sodium atomic number 11. Atomic mass that is 23. Okay.
Yeah.
So that means you have to understand that atomic mass just will be means approximately double of atomic number. Yeah. Understand? So
yeah. Here
with respect to that, here you are also seeing that element chlorine that you are seeing on your screen. Whatever that would like to be right in downwards, it is your atomic number, okay.
Okay.
Yeah.
So
and the above side, it is your atomic mass.
Okay. So what does this class as? So like 35 protons and 17 electrons. Does that mean that?
No. 17. Oh. That means it is your electrons. Okay.
Oh,
and here 35. That is your proton plus neutron. Okay.
Okay.
Yeah. As usual that they are also saying that atomic number and mass number, okay, that you can calculate with the help of subatomic particles. Okay. So that means this symbol, whatever you are seeing on your screen, as I explained that to you, having 17 protons, okay, or 17 electrons. So that is known as your atomic number. Okay.
Okay.
Understand? So that means number of proton and number of electron, that will be same. Okay.
Yeah.
This symbol also tells us that the total number of proton and neutron in the chlorine, that's are 35. That's okay. Why that I wrote there proton plus, yeah, you are seeing here proton plus neutron. Okay.
Okay.
As usual, you know that the total mass of an atom exists at nucleus. Okay.
Okay,
nucleus. Okay, so nucleus is where, that means the combination of proton plus neutron. Okay. So that means proton plus neutron, that is 35 is what? 35 is your atomic mass. Okay.
Yeah.
So number of proton that you know, that number of neutron, number of electron that you know that. So here beta, number of, you know that, okay, number of proton that you are seeing, and number of proton that is 17, number of electron that you are also understanding that is 17. Okay, so what will be the number of neutron? So that means what you have to do, that so you know that proton plus neutron, that is 35. Okay.
Five.
Here.
Yeah.
Okay. Yeah, so that plug in the value of proton, that is 17 plus neutron, that is 35. And neutron, that will be 18. Okay.
Okay.
So that means in chlorine, there will be 18 neutrons, 17 protons, 17 electrons. Do you understand it?
Yeah. Or you could just do 35, take away 17.
Oh, yes, that's right. Because 35, 17 is your atomic number, Atomic number, that means it can also be considered as number of proton or number of electron. So number of electron or number of proton, that is the same. So that means in nucleus there will be 17 proton, and the total, that is 35. So 35 minus 17, and you'll get that 18. So 18, that will be your number of neutron. Okay.
Okay.
Do you understand clearly?
Yeah.
Great. Now I'm going to refresh that button so that we can move to the next page. Now come to the third page over here. Did you see your previous video which I had uploaded there?
I didn't get to see it yesterday, but I'll see it today.
Okay, great. Next one is your third topic, that is isotopes. Isotopes are the atoms of an element with different number of neutrons. Okay? They have same proton number but different mass number. Okay? Isotopes are the substances having same proton number but different mass number. Or you can understand in this way. Suppose that one definition I am writing, isotopes, that is substance having what? Same atomic number. Okay.
Yeah.
Atomic number but different atomic mass. Okay.
Okay.
Different atomic mass. Okay.
Okay.
Yeah, that is known as isotopes. Okay.
Yeah.
So here whatever image that you are seeing, in that one, that they are explaining that every element means any element, there are many elements which have isotopes. So here you are seeing that regarding to hydrogen, that they are explaining that hydrogen having three isotopes. Okay. They are saying that as hydrogen 1, hydrogen 2, hydrogen 3, but for your kind information, beta, the first one is known as protium, okay?
Oh, protium, okay.
Protium. Second one is known as deuterium. And the third one having tritium, okay? Okay?
Okay.
Protium having 1 atomic mass. Deuterium having 2 atomic mass, tritium having 3 atomic mass, okay?
So, I'm just going to ask you a question.
Yo?
Isn't this got to do with chemistry?
Chemistry?
Yeah.
Yeah, it is also belongs to chemistry, yes. If I would, yeah, in chemistry also, that when we would like to study the chapter atoms, molecules and elements, okay? So, when I would like to explain atom, so in atom also I have to explain about that atomic number, mass number, nucleus, nucleons, okay, and isotopes, isobars and each and everything, okay. So that means whatever we are studying here in physics, but as I explained that to you, that science, that means each and everything that would like to originate through physics, okay.
Okay.
Yes. So they are interconnected. Okay, whatever concept that you would like to see in physics, the same type of concept that will also be in chemistry.
Okay.
Yes. Because it is not possible that whatever element that you are seeing surrounding to you, okay, they contains atoms. Okay. So if they contains atoms, so that means different type of properties they would like to hold. That means the pure substances, impure substances, and then means proton, neutron, electron, okay, in fundamental way, and then in that condition means physical property, chemical property, and then chemical equation, chemical reaction, okay, and onwards, okay, okay. Isotopes, isobars, isotones, okay, just like that. So here basically that isotopes that they are explaining, so isotopes that you have to understand what that means. Isotopes are the substances having same atomic number but different atomic mass. So how do you consider that they are having same atomic number? You can see that same atomic number, you can see that you are seeing here that only one proton, okay?
Yeah.
Only one proton. only one proton. Okay.
Is it that because you can't get like two nucleus? It's only one nucleus in the.
Nucleus that will be one. Nucleus that will be one. But in that nucleus, at different situation or conditions, there will be the number of proton or number of electron that would like to be different. Okay.
Okay.
Yeah. Or basically that you can understand that in protium there will be no neutron. Only there will be proton and electron, okay?
Okay.
And in deuterium, there will be one proton and one electron at the nucleus, or yeah, in the at the center. And in the tritium, you can see that there will be two neutron and one one proton will be there, okay?
Okay.
Yes, because the electron would like to revolve around the nucleus, so we don't have to consider about that one. Only you have to see that in protium, there is only one proton. In deuterium, there will be one proton, one neutron, and in tritium, one proton and two neutron there, okay?
Okay.
Or basically that you have to understand that in protium, there will be atomic mass 1, deuterium, there will be atomic mass 2, and tritium, there will be atomic mass 3, okay?
Okay.
And also you can see that 1, so 1 is here, so it is your atomic. It is atomic number, okay, and it is your atomic mass, okay?
Okay.
So atomic mass means what? Atomic mass, you can consider that proton plus neutron, that is equals to 1, okay?
Okay.
You are seeing that atomic number, that is number of proton or number of electron, okay? So 1 plus neutron equals to 1, so neutron, that is equals to 0. That's why that here you can see that there is no neutron, okay?
Okay.
In the second one, you can see that proton plus neutron, that is equals to 1. Oh, wait, sorry. By different color, it will be much convenient for you to understand. Hold on. Yep. So, proton plus neutron, that is equals to 2. Proton is 1 plus neutron, that is equals to 2. Therefore, neutron equals to 1. Okay. That's why you are seeing that there is 1 neutron. Okay.
Okay.
And the third one. And third one, if you would like to see there, that is proton plus neutron, that is equals to 3. Proton is your 1 plus neutron equals to 3. Therefore, neutron equals to 2. Okay?
Okay.
Having 2 neutrons. Okay?
Yeah.
Do you understand that?
Yeah.
Great. So, let's refresh that and there will be 10 questions that would like to come on your screen. You understand each and everything clearly?
Yeah.
In which one that you will feel problem, then I'll explain again that to you, okay?
Yeah.
So it's your 10th time and the 10 questions would like to appear on your screen, okay?
Okay.
Are you ready?
Yeah.
Great. First question is, what is the charge on proton?
Positive.
Plus 1. Great. Charge on electron?
Negative. Minus 1.
Charge mass of neutron?
No charge. No charge. 0.
Yeah. Mass of neutron? Almost 0.
Yeah.
What is mass of an electron?
I think it's almost 0.
Electron they are talking about.
Oh.
If you are seeing mass of neutron, that is 0. So they are asking about mass of electron.
Oh, electron is negative, minus 1.
Okay, negative 1.
So can you just scroll up? I just want to see something.
What?
Can you just go up? I just want to see my down. I mean, yeah. Okay, yeah,
great. Now, is they are saying that what is the charge of an ion which has lost an electron?
Okay.
That means they are asking that if an element that is losing electron, so what will be charge on that? Positive, negative, or neutral?
It is positive.
Great. That's right. It will be positive. And when at the charge, what will be the charge of an ion which has gained an electron?
Oh, negative.
Oh yes, that's the opposite of that, negative. And what is the atomic number of an atom?
Okay.
Number of neutron, number of proton, or number of electron?
It's number of neutrons.
Atomic number.
Oh, atomic number.
Yes, just read your question carefully, beta. Atomic number they are asking.
Number of protons.
Okay. What is the atomic number of an atom? So number of protons, okay. What is the mass number of an atom?
Okay. Protons, wait. Protons and neutrons.
Great. Number of protons and neutrons. And what are isotopes?
Okay. A different number of neutrons.
Okay, isotopes, that means atoms of same element with different number of neutrons. Okay, 9th. Okay, 10th one, they are asking how many neutrons does in hydrogen 3 have?
Neutrons, 0. No, wait.
Hydrogen 3 they are asking, that means tritium they are asking.
I think it's 2.
Okay. Yes, just before that you understand that. I explained that just before. I think.
Yeah.
Let's check that. How much did you get there? 8. Very good. That's great. So let's see that. Which question that you did wrong over there? What is the mass of neutron, beta? Mass of neutron that becomes 1, beta. Okay.
Yeah.
It is same as proton. Okay.
Okay.
Yeah. So that's why that your 2 question that was a little bit confusion that you got 2 question wrong. Okay.
Yeah.
Mass of neutron that is 1, and mass of electron that was approximately 0. You know.
Okay.
Understand?
Yeah.
Yes, because electron that used to revolve around the nucleus, okay, that is not inside the nucleus. So if that is, if anything that is outside of your house, so how is it possible that it will include in strength of your house? No. Means yeah. It is just like as condition. Suppose that there are 3 members in your house, okay?
Okay.
And 2 members are outside of your house. So if I would like to talk, if I would like to ask about the strength of your house, so what you will say? Is it possible? You will say that, sir, strength is with respect to 3 peoples, okay? Why? Because they are in your house. Or if you'd like to include that outside persons also, no. Because I'm asking about strength of your house.
Yeah.
Okay, it is also just like as suppose that if I would like to ask you that what is your body strength. So what is your body strength? That means whatever energy that is in your body, or suppose that the sun is outside of your body. So your energy will be also just like a sun. No.
Okay.
So strength, that means whatever energy that will be inside your body. Okay.
Okay.
So that means and your body contains mass. So whatever will be outside, that contains no mass. Okay?
Okay. Yeah.
Yeah. So these 2 questions due to a little bit mistake that were wrong. Otherwise, all the questions are right. Perfect. Very good. You got 80% in this one, beta. Great. So now, next topic.